Let's continue our discussion about Little John and Vindhya article Beyond Language Learning, some perspectives on materials design. And in this regard, we've got a subtopic within the main topic, which is the general knowledge, how language learning, in other words, could be taught through general knowledge topics based on drawn from general knowledge, apart from specialized or English for specific purposes topics. So before we proceed with our discussion of this module, I would just like you to take a little pause and pause the video for a while and think, just reflect on these questions and what you understand by the questions listed here. So the first question, what you understand by the term general knowledge for English language teaching? Secondly, how topics on general knowledge can offer basis for the teaching of English language? Thirdly, how can we teach English as lingua franca, which is language of international communication, in this world of business, trade, and tourism or commerce? Just think about these questions and see I would be pleased if you just could pause the video for a while and reflect on these questions. Right. Well, the general knowledge, the reason why some of the materials are designed or based on general knowledge topics, this notion is very much prevalent in our language teaching context, in the Pakistani context, from grade 1 to 12, if you look at our own national language curriculum design of 2006. Right. This concept of materials design sees language learning an end itself. And it's just based on, teaching language on some contents and which go beyond cross-curricular, which go beyond subjects. For example, Panio, of course, the content and English language, how it's taught based on some subjects, right? Little John, the main argument presented by the researchers in this article is their language teaching, should go beyond mere inclusion of topics on general knowledge. Rather, there should be some topics which are related to our social world and which we don't, the facts, the topics, the themes which we don't accept on their face value, rather, which engage learners to analyze them critically, right? And these could be about volcanoes, about animals, about, some space or universe, themes about, some medicines, right? Well, on the other hand, if you look at Cook's argument, so he argues, Guy Cook, big name in SLA, second language acquisition, that there are certain possibilities for real content coming in the shape of, another subject, like it could be subject of science or social sciences or students' content, students, what they actually perceive about language learning and the language itself. The grammar, the lexis, the phrases, the words, and the literature, exposing students to language learning via literature, based on literary texts. In the culture and literature are very much interrelated, because if we know well if we want to know the culture of the of a society, we first need to know its language, right? So these subjects, topics based on general knowledge, going beyond teaching for the sake of language, offer some interesting facts to the language learners. So in brief, materials design actually could be drawn on some general knowledge topics and these topics shouldn't be restricted as the argument proposed by Little John and Wendiat is not to, I mean, to be restricted to few topics. Rather, they should cross, go beyond the curricula and entail some subjects such as science, such as tourism, such as commerce, such as business. So there, we can have plenty of examples, I mean, basing our lessons on business, commerce, tourism. And this is how we can prepare our learners effectively for the recipients of English as a lingua franca.